In part 4 of our lesson on parametric equations, we will review how to graph a hyperbola with center 0, 0. First up, we have a horizontal hyperbola whose equation looks like x squared over a squared minus y squared over b squared is equal to 1. So first off, let's remind ourselves how to recognize that this will be a hyperbola. Both the x and the y will need to be squared, and they will need a minus sign between them. If there was a plus sign between them, then it would be an ellipse. So both of them have to be squared, and you need a minus sign between them. In this case, when the x squared is first, you will get this horizontal hyperbola in this picture here. So notice that the vertices are at plus and minus a, comma 0. So here is a vertex at a 0. The other vertex is here at negative a 0. A hyperbola has two asymptotes that you can see in the picture here. And we use a and b in order to get those asymptotes. We make a box going through negative a, negative b, a, and b. Then the asymptotes of the hyperbola are the diagonals of that box. Remember that we reviewed the slope-intercept form of equations of lines. So the intercept of these lines, both of them, is 0, 0. So the slope, we know, is rise over run. So when we look at this first asymptote, we know from 0, 0, we would go up by b and to the right by a. So that means the equation of this asymptote is y equals b over a times x. For this asymptote, we start at the origin, we go down by b and to the right by a, so that means its equation is y equals negative b over a times x. A horizontal hyperbola has two branches. This one is called the right branch. And not surprisingly, this one over here is called the left branch. We can find equations for the right branch and the left branch by starting off with the standard form for the horizontal hyperbola and do a little bit of algebra to solve for the x term. Now in this step, to go from x squared to x, we know we will be using the square roots property, and that's where the plus or minus comes in. Now when x is positive, you can see over here on the graph, the right branch, all of the x coordinates are positive. The y coordinates are sometimes positive and sometimes negative, but all of the x coordinates are positive. So when it is the positive square root, that will be the right branch. Looking again at the graph, we see over here on the left branch, all of the x coordinates of these points will be negative. The y coordinates are sometimes positive and sometimes negative, but all of the x coordinates are going to be negative. So when it's the negative square root, that will give us the left branch equation. Next, let's review the vertical hyperbola, whose standard equation is y squared over a squared minus x squared over b squared is equal to 1. Because both y and x are squared, and there's a minus sign, you know it's going to be a hyperbola. Because the y squared term comes first, you know that it is a vertical hyperbola. Underneath the y squared, you see there's an a squared, so the vertices are going to be at 0 plus and minus a. So we have a vertex here whose coordinate is 0, comma a, and the second vertex is here with coordinate 0, comma negative a. This hyperbola will have two asymptotes, and we see we use the a and b once again to make a box. The asymptotes will go through the corners of the box, and to get the equations, once again we see that the y-intercept is 0, 0, so then the equation of this asymptote will be y is equal to, we need its slope, starting from the origin we go up by a and to the right by b, so that means the slope is a over b, and then we take it times x. For this asymptote, we have y is equal to get the slope, we start at the origin, and this time we go down by a and to the right by b, so that means the slope is negative a over b times x. The hyperbola has two pieces. This is called the upper branch. And this piece is called the lower branch. And we can get the equations for the upper and lower branches, much like we did previously for the horizontal hyperbola, by starting from the standard equation, and this time do some algebra to solve for the y variable. To go from the step where y squared is to the step where y is, we know we're going to use the square roots property, which is where the plus and minus comes from. When we look at the upper branch, we see that the x coordinates will sometimes be negative and sometimes be positive, but all of the y coordinates in the upper branch are positive. So when we take the positive square root, we get the upper branch. Going back to the graph and looking at the lower branch, we see that the x coordinates are sometimes negative, sometimes positive, but all of the y coordinates down here are negative, so when we take the negative square root, we get the lower branch. So let's get some practice now at graphing a hyperbola. In this example, we have to graph 4x squared minus y squared is equal to 4. Now this is almost in standard form. We know that we need a 1 over here on the right hand side. So let's go ahead and divide both sides by 4. And our equation becomes x squared minus y squared over 4 is equal to 1. Now to get it in the standard form, we need a denominator here under the x squared, And we know that denominator would be 1. Now the center of our hyperbola is 0, 0. We see that the horizontal axis will be the square root of 1, which is 1. The vertical axis will be the square root of 4, which is 2. And we use these to make the box. So in the x direction, we go plus 1 and minus 1. In the y direction, we go plus 2 and minus 2. And we use that to make our box. We know that the asymptotes of this function have to go through the corners of the box. To get the equations of the asymptotes, let's do this first one here. We start at the origin and we see the slope is that we go up by 2 and to the right by 1, so that is a slope of 2, and the equation of this asymptote is y equals 2x. To get the equation of this asymptote, we start at the origin, we see that we go down by 2 and to the right by 1, which means the slope is negative 2, so this is y equals negative 2x. Looking at the equation that we got, the x squared comes first, so that tells us that this is going to be a horizontal hyperbola. And that was because the x squared is first. Then we know that the vertices of our hyperbola are going to be at plus and minus 1, comma 0, because it's whatever is under the x term. So we have a vertex here at 1, 0, and we have a vertex here at negative 1, 0. And then we know that the right branch has to approach the asymptotes, and the left branch has to approach the asymptotes. So to review, we worked the equation into standard form. Because the x squared came first in the subtraction, we knew it was a horizontal hyperbola, and the vertices would be at plus and minus 1, 0. The horizontal axis will be the square root of whatever is under the x term, which is 1, so the square root of 1 is 1. The vertical axis will be the square root of whatever is under the y term, so square root of 4 is 2, and using that 1 and 2, we make a box. And then that box leads us to our asymptotes. We plot the vertices, and then immediately can draw in the hyperbola. And this is the method you will use to graph hyperbolas whose center is at the origin.